How would you categorize anti-Semitism in Europe nowadays?
Its main variant is anti-Israelism. I mean, the three major developments in anti-Semitism. There is the original anti-Semitism, which is religious anti-Semitism. You can say Christian and Muslim anti-Semitism. Christian anti-Semitism has one core message, which is the core message of anti-Semitism throughout, say, 2,000 years. The Jews are absolute evil. Mm-hmm. Absolute evil then translates in having killed the alleged Son of God.
Right.
In the course of the centuries, at a certain moment, secularization begins. And if there is no God, killing the Son of God, if you did it or not, is anyhow irrelevant.
Sure.
So we get this ethnic nationalistic anti-Semitism, which again uses the core motif, but in a mutated form. It says the Jews are absolute evil because they are subhuman.
Mm-hmm.
And that gets then its lowest form, Nazism, which says they are vermin, they are bacteria, they have to be exterminated.
Mm-hmm.
Then after the Second World War, of course, that doesn't sell anymore. In fact, people don't want to be identified in it.
Mm-hmm.
And it mutates in a third form, anti-Israelism. The Jewish state is absolute evil. And what is absolute evil? It is a Nazi state. And that concept in various forms is today shared superficially by 150 million out of the 400 million adults of the European Union. We have statistics on that.
Yeah, that was the number of polls that you had on that, right?
Yeah, I have polls. They also contained in my major book, The War of a Million Cuts.
Mm-hmm.
So, to summarize it, the classic religious anti-Semitism attacks Judaism as a religion. The nationalist ethnic anti-Semitism attacks Jews as a people. The anti-Israelism attacks the Jewish state.
Just out of curiosity, because I'm just wondering how you would categorize, isn't there like a strain that also, instead of saying that Jews are vermin, but that Jews are super powerful, that they are... Would you put that under the same category, or
that is not the same category? But it's very important that we now finally have a definition of anti-Semitism since a fairly short time. The so-called International Holocaust Remembrance Assembly, a definition which takes over an earlier definition, but the importance of the IHRA definition is that the 31 member states of the IHRA, of which 24 EU states, had to agree that this definition, not legally binding, would be accepted by the IHRA. So we have a widely accepted definition. In that definition, you will find conspiracy theories.
Mm-hmm.
And that is an example of a conspiracy theory.
Sure, absolutely.